This kid couldn't speak. Everyone else in his peer group speaking all good. He couldn't speak. At age 7, everyone's reading and talking. He can't read. He was slowing down so much, the teachers brought his parents to the man and said, dude, the kid's gotta go, man. He's just slow. He's not creative. He's slowing down the betterment of the entire class. Gotta go. Parents brought him home and he's like, man, what are we gonna do with this child of ours? Too bad. They put him to work. He got fired from every single job he ever tried. All this guy knows up until 21 years old is failure. He's never tasted success. He just gets up and keeps trying, fails. Gets up, keeps trying. Until one day he found out what he wanted, what inspired him, and he gave it everything he had, day in, day out, man. He burned the midnight oil so he didn't have to stay awake in the midnight hours wondering what if. This guy tried something 1,093 times before it was successful. 1,093 times, man. When the hell have you ever tried something more than 10 times before you throw in the towel? I can't say I have. This guy did. And why? That was what he wanted. How was it nourished? Failure. Everything failed in his life. So when it failed like 1,000 times, he's like, well, f*** it, man. It's an average f***ing day. It always fails. I keep on going. But his invention got smarter and quicker. That failure made it more and more successful. It was getting closer and closer and closer. And finally, the light bulb lit. That was Thomas Edison. Failure. Dumbass his entire life. He had over another 1,000 patents, man. Remarkable. Couldn't speak at 4. Was written out of class because couldn't read at 7. Kicked home, saying mentally challenged. Remember the name of the person that overcame the odds. Because that same person you're going to use in your own battle one day. When you hit rock bottom and you feel like the walls and monkeys on your back and Murphy's hitting you down every single step. You're going to use that inspiration to take that one more step forward that makes all the f***ing difference. We all fall down in life, guys. The question is, who gets back up? Again, it's not the potential of the individual. It's not the genetics. It's the perseverance, the never say die attitude.
That's called courage. Now that's the stuff leaders should be made of.
If you constantly keep throwing shit against the wall, eventually something will stick, guys. Never give in to what you want. When you find out what you want, and you combine that with a sound mental diet, a visual nutrition, a physical diet of good food coming in with good exercise, you build the body, the belief, the confidence. You put that together with a want and a drive, dude, you're unstoppable.
Success, guys, a very, very lonely road, man. Very few people are willing to endure the pain, the sacrifice, the due diligence to be successful. It's an uphill battle. And along that road, you're not gonna see too many friends. You're gonna see your shadow most often. You gotta trust in the heart of hearts, inside what you're doing, what you believe in is a worthy cause, a winnable fight. The journey is not easy. But before you start that journey mentally, you must fuel yourself with the right reasons, the right fuel to sustain the entire journey. Everyone's hot off the start, but after a month or so into it, or a couple weeks into it, with the wear and tear and the grind starts to hit you, you start losing focus on the horizon, do you not? You get caught away in the daily hiccups, the ups and downs, and the wear and tear. And you focus on the speed bumps, the daily activities, losing sight of the true purpose. When you lose sight of the purpose, you give too much value of what the pain is today. Once you find out you want, regardless of what it is, then you combine the mind and the body together. That's when life gets exciting, guys. Stories of inspiration where the person overcomes the odds. And before you embark on this journey, mentally, you have to prepare yourself for it. No one's gonna get worse before it gets better. When you embark this journey, you must know that it's gonna go down before it comes up. But when it comes up, it's gonna go so much higher than you've ever been. Sacrificing today for tomorrow's betterment.
Greatness is here, but it ain't on Cam's shoulders no more. It ain't on Farley's shoulder no more. It ain't on Bo Jackson's shoulder no more. Now greatness is on whose shoulder?
You go after and you give it all you have. If you lose, at least you tried, man. I failed. It's 10 times more of a man than someone said, what if? Because what if never went to the arena.